mission, function, and organizational structure of clinical engineering services will be the topic of this lecture. The lecture will be divided into four parts. The first part will be about the mission. The second part will be about the policies and the procedures. The third part will be about a typical organizational chart for a healthcare technology program. And finally, we'll talk about the logistic models. So now we will start with the first part. In the first part, we'll talk about the hospital mission. Then we will talk about the mission at the departmental level. The mission at each department. For example, the healthcare technology program mission, the clinical or medical department mission, and so on. Then we will talk about the healthcare technology program requirements. Finally, we'll talk about the traditional and new trend roles and responsibilities. So, what is the hospital's mission or the organization's mission? The mission of a hospital is to improve the health of the communities we serve by delivering a broad range of high quality services with sensitivity to the needs of our patients and their families. So the goal of a hospital is to improve the health of the communities we serve. What does hospital is delivering of a broad range of high quality services with a sensitivity to the needs of our patients and their families. Now we will talk about the mission at the departmental level. We mean by that at for each department, clinical engineering department mission, the medical or clinical department mission, and so on. We can take an example for the mission of hospital mission, the University of Pittsburgh Medical Center. The University of Pittsburgh Medical Center has a capacity of 8,000 beds. It was founded in 1893. It has a number of employees around 85,000 employees in 2018. It has the asset was about 53 billion in 2017. So the healthcare technology program mission is to support the delivery of healthcare by ensuring the availability of safe and effective medical technology in a cooperative effort with other members of healthcare team. So our goal as a healthcare technology program to support the delivery of the healthcare, what we do is to provide safe and effective medical technology, and how we do it in a cooperative effort with other members of the healthcare team. The mission statement: the Office of the Engineering Services will apply engineering, technical, and managerial expertise in order to provide safe, effective, and economical facilities as needed by a university hospital or a general hospital for patient care, teaching, research, and community service. So now we will talk about the requirements for such program. For the program, first of all, has to control and monitor equipment performance through routine performance testing, initial inspection of new equipment, preventive maintenance, repair and action reports in a device, hazards and recalls. The second requirement is that accurately and regularly computes and monitors the total equipment maintenance cost. So we should monitor monitor and compute the total cost, equipment maintenance cost, in-house and out-house. Out-house, we mean by that a manufacturer or third-party services. The third requirement in such a program is the involvement in all aspects of the equipment acquisition and replacement decisions, development of new services, and the planning of a new construction and major renovations. The fourth requirement of such a program will be the development of a training program for both the equipment users and the biomedical equipment technicians. The fifth requirement is a quality assurance program relating to the use of technology. The final requirement will be the risk management as it relates to the technology. Now, the traditionally, we were responsible for only the technical service, which means the scheduled and unscheduled maintenance. The unscheduled maintenance, which includes the inspection and testing, functional testing, safety and performance, calibration, preventive maintenance, and repair. Whereas in the new trend, which covers not only the technical services, but include another type of services, which is the technology management services. This will include the equipment management program, risk analysis and control analysis and control elements, the evaluation of new technologies prior to acquisition through the performance of a life cycle cost analysis, service vendor management, a compliance with the government and accrediting standards, educational services, equipment users, and as we said, it's separated into equipment users and biomedical equipment technicians. Finally, a device tracking, hazard and recalls, and the incident reporting and investigations.